Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while, and as you can tell, I've had a change of scenery, so that's why I've been very, very busy. But we're back, and I have a brand new series for you guys, where I'm going to be talking about all things NASA. First of all, just a few updates. Number one, I am using this brand new microphone right here, so if it's rubbing against my shirt or my body, I'm sorry. I'm learning how to use it, and I won't know how it sounds until I'm editing, so fingers crossed, but we'll see. Now, as you may have noticed, I didn't really talk about where I worked, what I did at work on my channel. I was pretty vague, and that's just personal preference. I don't really like to give too many details about my current place of employment, which is why I'm talking about it now. I decided to take a leave from working so that I can focus on grad school. Now, you may remember that I did attempt to work full-time, do grad school part-time, and then do my science communication and social media work also part-time, but it was honestly just too much for me, so I decided to talk to my supervisors. They were extremely supportive, and we all agreed that the best thing for me would be to focus on grad school and, you know, finish up as soon as I can so I can get back to my work. So if you guys have any questions about that, feel free to drop them here and I'll definitely talk about it. So let's get started. NASA. This is going to be a series of videos talking about all things NASA. This first video is going to focus on how I got my NASA internship. Then I can talk about how I was able to turn that internship into a full-time position in another video. Then I have another video called what it's like to work at NASA plant. So if you have any other video ideas, be sure to drop them here so I can add them to this series. Okay, how I got my NASA internship. Let's get started. Then after that, I'm going to look through my story because I left a question sticker and I'll be answering some questions. For the next few videos, be on the lookout on my story as well. If you have any specific questions, you can ask them there or you can leave them down in the comments and I'll address that in the future videos. When I was at community college, I applied to transfer with a 4.0. I had a very good GPA, a very good application. I had so many extracurriculars and volunteer work, and it was honestly a solid application. And it showed because I was able to get the Regent Scholarship at UCLA. Coupled with the Jack Kent Cooke Foundation Scholarship, I was able to have not only a full ride education, but also all of my expenses like rent, books, bills, everything of that nature completely paid for. And I actually had some left over as well. So that was honestly a huge help for me. Definitely, if you're in that position to apply to those scholarships and you're scared, just do it. I do have another video about my scholarships and kind of my community college experience. So if you're interested in that, I'll link it down in the description. But let's move on. So I get to UCLA, right? I decided to go to UCLA. There's this whole thing. I wanted to go to Berkeley originally and I changed my mind. And that's a whole other mess that I talk about in another video as well. But anyway, so I'm here. I'm at UCLA and I kind of was used to being the best student, right? And now I'm at a school where everyone here is used to being the best student. I was terrified. I was doing so badly. I was not used to the quarter system. When you transfer, that first quarter now becomes your GPA because your community college GPA sort of, it's not like it's wiped, but as far as the UC is concerned, they only took the units and not the actual grades. So you have a different GPA when you start out, and you can list your community college GPA on your resume as part of your community college education. But as far as your current GPA, that would be your UC GPA. And for me, my first quarter, it was bad. Let's just put it that way. And this is the GPA I had to use to apply for internships, okay? I don't even want to think about those days. I felt so defeated. I felt so bad. And I mean, I not only did I feel that way, but I was also getting a lot of rejections from the places I was applying for, which kind of just was reinforcing that whole like, well, I'm not good enough. I shouldn't even be applying for these things. I'm just wasting my time. So I stopped applying pretty much for that whole first summer that I was going to be spending at UCLA. And I was really down, but at the same time I thought, you know, okay, So I did have experience though. I think a lot of it really was me telling myself no before they could, to just protect myself in a way, but that's not the right way to do things. So that first summer, I didn't get anything, and that was my doing, to be honest. That was completely my doing. It was my own insecurity. Because I did have experience. I had research experience. I had had another internship already. So it really was just me being scared of rejection. But particularly, I was scared of rejection from the one place I had always dreamed of, you know, NASA. So I didn't even apply. But what I did do was that summer, I spent it teaching myself how to use the professional software for PCB design that is used in industry. Because in industry, at least not that I've seen, no one's using, you know, Eagle or things like that. They're using Altium, they're using Cadence. So I spent that summer working at McDonald's, because yeah, girl had bills to pay, and teaching myself PCB in the afternoons and sleeping in my parents' attic, or it was like a little basement room. So that's what I did. And I added that to my resume. I made sure to really develop that skill, and I started applying. I started applying and applying and applying. I went to conferences. I really got out of my comfort zone and spoke to a lot of these different companies, and particularly NASA and JPL at the conferences. And I was able to make some pretty good connections. Particularly, I believe my position eventually came from a talk I had with an engineer at a SHIP conference. If you don't know what SHIP is, that's the Society of Hispanic Professional Engineers. I went to the conference in Kansas City, Missouri, and I spoke to someone there. And I remember, I distinctly remember this, right after speaking to them and handing over my resume, I remember seeing them put my resume in a really small pile, and he like marked something on it. So I was like, did I do it? But then I also remember that during that same conference, I had some other classmates who were getting interviews with JPL, and I didn't really hear back. So I was like, man, but you know, it's a learning experience, and I kept applying. Now, I don't really remember when that conference was, but I want to say it was in the fall. And the following year, around March, I had already forgotten about this and pretty much thought I didn't get it. I get an email from someone at JPL, NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab, asking me if I'd be interested in a internship that would be during the school year. So not in the summer, it would be for the spring quarter. Of course, I said, heck yes. And I decided to go through with the interview. Now, when I tell you I cried, my husband can attest to this. He probably thought that like something horrible happened, because I just started ugly crying, like Kim Kardashian ugly crying. That was me. And he comes over and I show it to him, and I don't know, it was just such an emotional experience for me, because after everything that I've gone through, if you don't really know my story, I'm not sure if I've told it to you guys here, I've gone through some stuff, you know, I've gone through a lot. I come from not much, and I've been able to do all of this by myself. So that moment is just, I don't know, it was really special for me. Now, I've never prepared for an interview as much as I prepared for this interview. And the reason for that was that once I actually read the job description, it was more for a software engineering position. And I'm an electrical engineer who specializes in electronics. I do have to take several programming classes as part of my degree, but I did not want that to be my career. But, you know, a foot in the door is a foot in the door, especially at a place like JPL. So I got myself as ready as I could. I looked up the engineer who was going to be interviewing me, looked up all the projects they've been a part of. I looked up all the current missions, past missions. You know, I basically took it as an opportunity of, if I don't get this position, I still have a NASA engineer on the phone with me. So when it comes to the Q&A portion, I have a lot of questions for them. You know, how do you like your job? What's the coolest project you've been a part of? Have you switched positions a lot? What's been your favorite project? What's been your favorite role that you've had, you know? So these are all the questions that I gathered for him and I asked him, and we had such an amazing conversation where it was kind of just like two people talking and enjoying a conversation after the interview. And I remember that when it ended, you know, we had such a good talk that right before he hung up, he said to me, "I genuinely believe that you belong here. And I don't want you to get discouraged. This isn't the only position out there. So please keep applying. You belong at JPL." And I just thought, oh no, I didn't get it. You know, because I don't know, how else am I supposed to take that? Which on one hand, it's a very nice thing for him to say that I belong here, you know, after everything that I've gone through and all of those feelings of insecurity and of self-doubt and self-rejection. For him to say something like that to me, it was really beautiful. But at the same time, I was hearing what he was saying. And what he was saying is, he doesn't want me to give up because I didn't get this one. Now, you know, that was fine because we had a great conversation and I did take his words to heart that I was gonna keep applying. There were other positions and, you know, time to move on. Now, what I didn't know was that behind the scenes, he liked our interview so much that he went back to the team that was actually hiring. He wasn't the one that I was going to be working with. He was just the one interviewing. He went back to the team and they had a discussion. And thanks to that interview, they decided that they would add on another position for a electronics intern. And then they would choose somebody else for the software position. So yes, I didn't get the software position. However, they opened up another position for me so that I could come and have my internship there as well. So if you take anything away from this video, please let it be that a foot in the door is a foot in the door. An opportunity is an opportunity. And just because an opportunity looks like maybe it's not what you're looking for, doesn't mean that you shouldn't give it your full 100% effort and energy. Because that's what I did, and I was able to secure my position out of nothing. So, of course, actually, this is another funny story. So he calls me up, that same engineer, and I was sleeping, I was taking a nap. And I remember I just saw the area code for La Cañada, which is where JPL is located. And I thought, oh shoot, I think that's him. So I answer, but I'm still kind of drowsy. And I'm just like, hello. And he tells me, you know, like they really want to extend a position to me. He tells me a little bit about what it's going to be, how it's going to be an electronics position. And I was still like, you know those naps where you wake up and you don't even know what day it is, like you don't even know what dimension you're on? That's the kind of nap I woke up from. And I remember I kind of was just processing, and I guess I stayed quiet for a little bit too long because I just heard him go, "Is that okay? Do you accept?" And I was like, "Oh, yes, yes, I'm so sorry. Yes, thank you." And then we hang up, and I don't know, I think I was just so excited but so terrified at the same time, because this is just, you know, everything I've been working for. Now, when I told my parents, because obviously my mom has known all my life that I wanted to eventually work at NASA, I remember I sat her down with my stepdad, and I was with my husband boyfriend at the time, and we were like, "We have to tell you something." And she thought I was gonna tell her that I was pregnant. And so she was just like, and she really wants a grandchild, so she was so excited. So when I told her, like, "No, I got a position at NASA for an internship," she was just like, "So no baby?" And I was just like, "No, no baby, NASA baby." All right, so that concludes this story time about how I got my internship. Now we're gonna get right into the Q&A portion for this video. All right, ignore my phone. Now some of these questions I'm going to be answering in another video if it's a little bit more relevant in that video. So I'm gonna be looking through some of these, choosing some, and answering them now. Are there any opportunities for international students? Yes, there are a few different programs for international students, and I also have a list on my blog with different opportunities you can apply for depending on your current level and status. So I will link that down in the description. Check that out. It's called Opportunities in Aerospace. And I will also leave down there a list of the different internships and programs you can apply for if you're an international student. How do you get someone at NASA to review your resume? So the best and easiest way would go to a conference that NASA is also attending. That is, honestly, I think that's why I was able to get my position, because later on I found out that that person I spoke to at the SHIP conference, I forgot to mention this, was that same person who emailed me and asked me for the interview. So it was the same man that I met at that conference who had separated my resume, marked something on it. It was him. So if you are really interested in NASA, I would definitely recommend going to a conference and speaking to someone. And if you want someone to, for example, review your resume, maybe let you know if there's anything you can improve on it, be honest with them and tell them, hey, can you please let me know if there's anything here that's not too clear, anything here I can improve, or is there anything that you're looking for that you don't see on my resume? They're people too. I promise you, they're really, really nice. The recruiters from JPL are so, so kind, and they would love to do that for you. Here's another question. What was the interview process like? So the interview process for an internship was, I wouldn't say it was scary at all. It was a phone interview, and so I did have to find a quiet spot, make sure that I had enough service. You know, last thing I want is my call to drop while I'm having an interview. It was pretty short. I think it was maybe like 30 minutes. And we mostly spoke about things on my resume, my experience. They had me talk about the projects I've been involved in, just explaining the complexity, the projects themselves, any difficulties I've had with them, and just kind of going a little bit deeper into my technical skills. There weren't really any technical questions that I got. That all came later during the actual internship. So for the most part, I'd say that it was actually a really pleasant experience and I really enjoyed it. But I do know that different groups work differently. So when I was actually interviewing for my intern, because we had an intern for a summer, well, a few interns, we did ask them a few technical questions. But don't be afraid, because some of the people we ended up hiring didn't actually even know the answer. What they did was they sent us an email a few hours later with pictures of their textbooks and the answers written out, saying, thank you for this question. Here are the answers. You know, I'm a really quick learner and I really wanted to thank you again for your time. So that to us showed us that they were extremely proactive, and that it doesn't really matter if you don't know it now, you're gonna go and find out without me having to tell you. So keep that in mind. In the next video, I'm going to talk about what my internship experience was like. I didn't want this one to be too long. So if you have any questions about that, drop them down. We're going to talk about everything. Imposter syndrome, feeling like you're not good enough, feeling like you're not going to finish your project, how to communicate with your supervisors, how to communicate with other interns. So all that good stuff we're going to talk about. Stay tuned. And thank you for watching. Please feel free to subscribe, feel free to like, feel free to comment. It really helps me out a lot. I know I've been absent for quite a bit, but I'm going to really, really try to get back into it. And I have a few new series that I'm going to be starting, some relating to electronics, so stay tuned for that. And thank you so much for being here, for watching, and for supporting me. It really helps a lot. Bye.